just a really exciting time to be out at Chimney Hollow Reservoir. We've been able to hit a lot of project milestones out here. We hit our maximum production on site, working double shift, 24 hours a day, 6 days a week, with 500 people on site on any given day to help us build the largest reservoir that's been built in the United States this century. And we are on track to meet our goals to deliver 30,000 acre feet of water to our 12 participants by the year 2025. The population of Northern Colorado is growing. The Chimney Hollow Reservoir Project provides a solution to addressing the water supply needs for our future generations.
Hi everybody, and welcome to the winter 2024 edition of the Chimney Hollow virtual tour. My name is Becky Brush. I'm a project engineer at Northern Water, and I'm out here at Chimney Hollow. We're standing here on the eastern ridge of the construction site, and before we go down and take a look at everything, let's take a look around up here. On the far north, you can see our main office over there, valve house, and the headworks for the downstream tunnel. We also have the spillway going up. And then we have the main dam embankment. And then we also have crushing facility and the quarry. We have the on-site asphalt batch plant as well as the concrete plant. And you can't quite see it from here, but about 2.5 miles south is the saddle dam. So we'll head down to the valley and we'll stop at the valve house, the tunnel, main dam, and aggregate processing plant. And we'll get to hear from the experts at each of those locations. Let's head on down.
I'm Grant Jamison. I'm a project engineer for Barnard Construction, and my scope is specifically the mechanical and the piping on the project and how it all comes together in the valve house.
Hi, I'm Dustin Hack, superintendent for Barnard. We'll be finishing concrete operations, which will be great. We'll have that knocked out here in a couple months. The ramp will be built. All the parapet walls will be up. We'll be finishing the staircases. This is all subterranean up to the level of the thickened wall. So that'll be starting to get backfilled. We'll set 4 or 5 more valves, and then we're waiting for them to ship from Germany. So that the rest of them won't come in until beginning of May. And then we'll finish out, we'll start doing the miscellaneous metals, they call it, which is all the walkways and platforms to access all these areas that the maintenance guys need to get to.
Once the concrete is done for all the parapets around the structure, the still building subcontractor Lefevre will come in and erect an entire structure all the way over top of all the concrete you see here. That will be about 80 feet tall once it is complete, and that will be the housing and the protection that protects all these valves here. All of our work here within the valve house, it will be complete, valves installed, piping installed by the end of June 2024, which then opens up for the subcontractor Lefevre to come in and install the building.
Hi, my name is Kyle Kittle, and I work for Stantec on site here at Chimney Hollow as the lead tunnel engineer. So the Chimney Hollow Inlet Outlet Tunnel has been divided into two headings. So after we drill and blast it all the way to the end of the valve chamber, we stopped and we picked up on the upstream side, and start at station 2, and then we're going to mine all the way to the valve chamber.
I'm Colin Hazeman with Barnard Construction, project engineer. Right now you're looking at the upstream portal. Crews are underneath. We're walking the road header into the heading. Get ready to start mining again. We're hoping to punch through and connect both tunnels here in the next month and a half, depending on how the ground goes, but hoping to hole through here soon.
After we hole through, then we'll start operations in the grout chamber. So we'll tie into our foundation curtain from the grout chamber using consolidation rings. And then after that, we'll start installing conduit and backfilling and then grouting through the conduit.
So footage varies depending on ground type. We get into this hard sandstone. We can go anywhere from 5 to 7 foot a shift if we're in drill and blast. The road header will slow down probably 3 to 5 feet. If we get back into a mudstone, a softer rock, we'll swap back to the road header primarily, and you can pull 6 to 10 foot a shift.
It's been really great working out here. A lot of great professionals from all over, so it's been really exciting to get to work with everybody on such a world-class project.
My name is Jordan Hall. I'm a lead project engineer for Barnard Construction here out on Chimney Hollow. A day in the life of a project engineer, first and foremost, is to ensure crew members and superintendents in the field have everything they need to succeed. Whether it be design clarifications, cost analysis, material procurement, production goals, potential design changes, and so on. We're here to provide information and the tools they need to progress their work. Engineers perform quality control inspections alongside the owner's quality assurance team to verify all permanent work is installed per project drawings and specifications. So behind me, we've got the 24-inch minus zone 4 rock fill obtained from the quarry being placed on the upstream side of the dam. We also have the foundation cleaning crews prepping the rock foundation for embankment. We've got filter crews out here placing different sized rock on top of the rock foundation, as well as in the distance we have asphalt placement occurring. So 2024 is expected to be our biggest year yet. We plan to place over 5 million cubic yards of zone 4 rock fill. Foundation grouting should be complete in mid-2024. We intend to place over 250 lifts of asphalt, gaining the elevation of the core 180 feet for this year. We're about halfway done with embankment, and each lift of zone 4 rock fill is getting smaller quantity-wise. A project of this scale requires a substantial team working together on a daily basis to complete the task at hand. Safety, quality, and teamwork are the top priorities out here.
My name is Andrew Pugh. I work for Black & Veatch. I'm the quality assurance inspector for the quarry and crushing operations here at Chimney Hollow. I oversee the quality assurance program related to quarry and crushing operations. I make sure that Barnard and their subcontractor are producing engineered spec material, as well as making sure that the material coming from the quarry for the crusher meets the intended quality spec. So here at Chimney Hollow, all the material required for the main dam, saddle dam, concrete, asphalt, road base are all produced here on site. Contractors self-loading in the quarry, they'll load their 75-ton haul trucks, bring those over to our 2 feed piles behind me here. They'll take that material, they'll load it into our primary jaw crusher, and then from there, depending on the mode and the material type we're trying to produce, it'll go to various stockpiles and through crushers, screen decks, and wash plants. So we use the material on site for 8 different products. We have zone 1, which is our hydraulic asphaltic core. We have our zone 2, which is a filter material for the asphalt core. Zone 3 is a filter material that protects the zone 2 from the larger zone 4 material, which makes up most of our embankment. our 5A, 5B material. 5A is sand, 5B is a 2-inch minus aggregate. Those operate as filters against the foundation that will help groundwater and surface water work through the structure without causing any issues long-term. In addition to all the main dam materials, everything needed to produce and build the saddle dam will be made out of this crusher, as well as sourced from on-site, as well as all the aggregate for the asphalt, concrete, bedding sand for the spillway, and any riprap, which is our zone 6 material, which will be higher in the dam structure to protect it from wave action. The crusher right now in winter months is running about a 25-day working month and crushing anywhere from 12 to 16 hours a day, depending on weather. By the time that the quarry and crushing operations will have ceased, we'll have produced about 2.5 million tons of material. Right now, we're on track to be completed by October of 2024. If, for reference, all of that material had been hauled off-site, that would have required 25,000 trucks per year for 4 years, which is the length of our project. By producing all of the aggregate here on-site, not only are we reducing the impact to the community, but also when we're done with production and placement, and the reservoir is full, you won't be able to even tell that this was here.
Thank you all for joining us on this virtual tour. We hope you enjoyed hearing from all the experts from around the site. Please check back this summer for our next update, and we'll see you then.